Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
The wedding out of Tokyo. Say hello to the amazing Brian Tichy!
He has played or recorded with White Snake, Ozzy Osbourne, Foreigner, Billy Idol, touring with the Dead Daisies this summer opening tour, Bad Company, Leonard Skinner, Kiss, and Def Leppard. Please welcome to Drumsmack TV, Brian Tichy.
Hello, up, how you doing?
Awesome. What's up, man?
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Thanks
for having me.
Dude, man, thanks so much for taking the time, because I hear from a lot of people like Kim and, you know, Noel, I mean, rather.
Yeah.
Like, you're a busy dude.
Yeah, you know. Well, you know, we take on a little bit too much, and then we try and squeeze it into a little too short of a period of time, yeah. And then you can consider yourself busy. let's put too much on the plate and squeeze it into a month when it should be six, and then just brag about how busy we are. Oh, I'm so busy, I can't. But it makes for good excuses when, you know.
I've started using the word hectic. It just has a little more, you know,
frantic.
Something frantic.
That's an older school word, probably not used to.
Frantically hectic.
Yeah, there
right,
you go.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey,
busy.
Well, look at
there you are.
All right. All
so
right.
I'm glad I wore this shirt.
Yeah.
So I'm glad I bought. Come on. This is forget the. Look at that. Come on.
Okay. That's, now you gotta fill in our audience.
I can't
on that.
Play it. I just walk around with it.
You're shedding a whole like you're practicing for the last 30 minutes before.
Did you say shed?
Yeah, I did say shit.
What,
I mean,
how far
I
does
mean,
that carry outside
I mean,
of Berkeley?
I mean, sure.
Hey, it go, at least carries down to Texas.
Yeah.
I mean, North Texas here.
Okay, that's a popular, that's another one that where you're allowed to say shed, right?
Yeah.
Does anybody have a, you know, some kind of DVD out? Because if you do, if you don't rip this off from me, but shedding and shredding, right? There's
right.
Shed and shred.
Yeah.
That should be the instructional video.
Shed and shred.
I think. Shed and shred. Shred and shed. What's easier? Shred and shed. Shed and shred. Shed and shred. Shed to shred.
You can market that to directly to Berkeley students and make a living.
Shed to shred. let me. There you go. Ryan just shed to shred.
Boom.
And you're like.
And then hold up the guitar. Game over.
Like,
then hold up this guitar.
It, like all this. Shed to shred. All right. Let's make
it
happen.
Wait, but you haven't told us about it.
So tell us about. I mean, there's a story behind this.
Yeah,
like, there's
well,
a story behind everything.
Yeah, but this is, I'll try to make it quick. Yeah. This is a Sandoval polka dot flying V. It's a polka dot. They call the polka dot V for obvious reasons.
Why is that particularly? Because
clearly
there's white polka dots on
this
it.
This is, okay. No, Sandoval, Carl Sandoval made Randy Rhoads this guitar. Not this exact guitar, so don't show up here and think you're going to like run away with it and stuff and knock me on my ass on the sidewalk.
Oh, man. Okay,
car.
Cancel our plans to
we
do that. We were going to do that.
I
but,
know.
Okay,
but,
we can't
but like,
do that.
You got bodyguard over here. Murphy's got your back, bro.
You know what? You got the DVD of the soundtrack bodyguard over there.
Shred and shed.
So Sandoval, this is an exact replica of the Randy Rhoads polka dot V. This is like just exactly to the same specs. So if you felt this neck, it's not your stand. It feels like a classical guitar neck.
It's wider neck, right?
Much wider, yeah. It's kind of a beast to play. It's really cool. It's a lot of fun. So I just got this. Our buddy who helps with all these shows, we do the Randy Rhoads Remembered and Ox and Loon and Bonzo Bash Phil Agent. I was just before we all hooked this up or later after we talked today.
Sure.
I was like, I got to get this guitar because the owner is allowing us to take it to these Randy Rhoads Remembered shows we're doing on the East Coast, which is June 3rd to June 8th. So with his schedule going away for the holiday weekend and mine and everything, I was like, Phil, you live kind of close to him. Is there any chance we can make this happen by tomorrow? And he was like, well, I got time tonight. And then Chris was like, well, you can come to my house and grab this tonight. And I was like, I can't. But Phil, if you get it and you meet me in Hollywood, this can be like really great for me because it's a lot of driving to get over there. Where, you know, so that's how it worked out. So Phil was just here with us and he had to split.
Right.
And that's why this guitar is here. I didn't bring it to Drumsmack. I know. Hey, I show up at drum interview related things with
the guitar. With the flying bee.
Randy remembered. Where can people find out more about those shows?
Just Facebook, like anything. It's like I forgot about updating my website because you're so busy on Facebook and Twitter doing all that, you know. But yeah, it's you just go to Facebook. Randy Rhoads Remembered Facebook page, really. And it's all there. And there's five shows on the East Coast. And it's great. It's all about guitar. It's about Randy. Right. But within that world, you're talking, you know, Ozzy Osbourne pretty much. You're talking Quiet Riot, which means you got to include drummers in that world. Like start with let's go to Frankie Benali, Quiet Riot. Then you have in the Ozzy world Lee Kerslake, who did the records. Then he moved into Tommy Aldridge world, and after Tommy, you go into you had Dean Castronova for a bit on a record. You had Mike Borden, Randy Castillo. Why am I spacing over Randy? Randy, like, so you got a bunch of killer rock drummers all the way up to. Tommy Clufetos now is playing with Sabbath and plays with Ozzy, and I was in there in 2000. So even when you speak of Randy Rhoads, there's a bunch of, forget me bringing my name in there, dropping my name, but I'm saying all those other guys.
You don't have to gloss over it. That's cool.
But I'm saying they're all killer drummers, you know?
That's
these
are guys. It right
there? Oh, look at that, yeah.
Look at this, these guys on
point.
Oh,
I just put that, yeah, look at that awesome picture. It's all great. I got stories for everything. I love our poster. Jay Bamberry did the our main poster that you see, the black and white that we, you know, that's his photo. And there you go.
It is.
That was the original show, January 25th. So the great thing is within the Bonzo Bash show, you know, we have tons of drummers playing on the Bonzo replica kit. But in the Randy shows, I get to be the drummer for the night, with the exception of when I played one song on guitar. Ray Luzier came up and played, because I've been friends with Ray a long time, and he loves all that stuff, you know. And he's an amazing drummer. Right. So, but the cool thing is with Bonzo Bash, it's a great show for what it was supposed to be. It is exactly what it's supposed to be. But with Randy, I'm like, I put all this time in the show, and I get to play drums all night. You know, I get to play. The goal is to play every song of Blizzard of Oz and Diary of a Madman. And I know those inside out. I grew up practicing to those, you know. It was, and with Rudy Sarzo on bass in these shows. The original one had Rudy Sarzo and Phil Sasson at the NAMM show, January 25th it was. It was split. The bass duties were split up by Phil Sasson and Rudy. And Rudy and I did a month together in Queensryche last summer, and we played a little bit together this year. And it was awesome. When I thought of doing the show, I was like, well, if Rudy's into it, that's gonna, you know, if Kelly Rhoads, the Rhoads family, and Rudy say yes, then I got a show. I can really move with this, you know. If they don't say yes, I'm really not gonna bother, you know. But when Rudy said, yeah, I was like, oh, because you know, this is Rudy. This is a guy that, you know, when you're first exposed to Randy Rhoads and Ozzy. And you hear, we know the records, those two records are Lee Kerslake and Bob Daisley, which they're amazing performances, and Bob Daisley's so integral to the finished product of those records, you know, and even beyond those records. But like Rudy was the guy carrying those tours that we all kind of got, you know, when you hear Ozzy's coming to town, Diary of a Madman tour, you know, and you see that stage, which is still to the day, one of the coolest, if not the coolest, outside of Van Halen Fair Warning stage, one of the most badass rock stages ever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And there's Rudy. So we like, I'm playing with Rudy, and we're all like that. We're all of us at this show, these Randy Rhoads Remembered shows. It's like we're all going on stage like Phil X or, everybody. Who is there? Bumblefoot. You know, like we're all like, wow, I get to play Rudy.
That's,
you know what
so
I mean?
Cool.
It's like, wait, Rudy, live this. You know, we're celebrating it. This is his life, you know?
Wow. I think it's so fantastic that you're doing, you started doing the Bonzo Bash, right, in like 2010? Is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, on the 30th,
anniversary?
The anniversary of his passing, September 25th, and it just ended up being a Saturday night in L.A. at the Key Club.
Right.
My partner, Joe Sutton, we're buddies. He's a promoter and stuff. And I was like, Joe, I want to do the show. I have this idea. You know, because initially it was just supposed to be a rehearsal room. You know, like just, you know, get a keg of beer and have everybody come down and play, and your friends learn that, you know, they're the house band, and you just make a night of it. And I'm like, but if I actually call these drummers, and you really do have Stephen Perkins and Frankie Benali and Kenny Aronoff, I'm like looking at this list, I'm like, and you're going to make it just a little private party? I'm like, wouldn't people, this is something that you don't see
people want to see
every day.
That.
Like, especially on a Saturday night the anniversary of. And Jason Bonham closed the show. And
that's huge.
Whole family ended up being here in town. So it was Deborah Bonham singing Since I've Been Loving You, Zoe Bonham singing When the Levee Breaks, Pat Bonham up there in the VIP table, you know, and we're all like sitting on, get on stage on this kit.
Just like, is
this
really
happening? You're already tripping out, you know, it's a little bit overwhelming.
Is this really happening? Like, that's,
you know,
amazing.
When I look back at it, I was like, it was just an idea. It was a nice little idea that was seen through. Because you know how you get ideas and you go, like you guys with the show. It's like some guys will talk, sit around, talking a lot of talk about this show idea, but they never get to this point that you guys are at right now.
Yeah,
but
you got to follow it through with action.
Yeah, so there's the people that actually make things happen, then there's the guys with the great ideas, and I feel like I have a lot of pretty cool ideas, but most of them don't get seen through. There's only so many hours in the day. There's only so many options you have to get things happening within your life as it is, and this was one of those that made it through. And really, it was just, okay, I've been around kind of a long time, and I know a lot of these guys. Some of them I've only crossed paths with like a Frankie Benali. We're buds, but it wasn't like we really knew each other that great.
Right.
And but I was so psyched when he was like, yeah, I'm available, I'm into it, you know, because because I knew he would bring the spirit and, you know, make the show what it was, you know.
Like that.
Like so, the polka dots, you know.
So coming up in, what is it? It's New Jersey, right? It's going to be, would have been Bonham's 66th birthday.
It's hard to do the math at this point, yeah. But
66,
I think it is.
And it's May 31st, Saturday
May 31st
night.
At the Bergen Performing Arts Center, the Bergen Pack. They call it the Bergen Pack. Just say it with like one word, Bergen Pack.
Bergen Pack.
It's an awesome venue. It's a killer theater. They're all great there. It's just like you just want to do a week's run. You just want to do a residency there. It's awesome. Sounds great. They're all like very accommodating and everything. Yeah, they're awesome.
Name some of the guys that are going to be performing.
Wow. Let me think. Now there's we cut it down a little bit this time. A lot of guys were going on tour, so we didn't go over like the 25 something drummers.
You didn't do the
15.
NAMM like 6-hour marathon.
I have a really hard time saying no to anybody, so yeah. I always go to the drummers that played and I go, who's available? And they all like, you know, most of them, yeah.
They're like me.
Some people can't. You know, sometimes things happen, but most of them are. And then it's like, I can't, how do you say, well, I have to cut. It never happens. So it just gets bigger. It's like, I haven't said
Sorry,
to one
Portnoy.
Person ever, you can't play. And because right. then it's like, oh, why? Am I not popular enough? Or is it like, oh, what, did I not do a good enough job on the song? Like, is it, I don't have, no, man, it's just how long. We knew we could get close to 40 drummers, and we almost made two nights of it. So it was like, well, 2020 is better, you know, maybe better two nights. But then I was like, there was other reasons that didn't happen. So we had the second night on hold. And I was like, why don't we do something badass? Randy Rhoads remembered. There you go. Yeah. That's why that happened.
Nice.
It was just like, we have it. What do you give it away? Or you do something else badass. But that just made the workload double. I wasn't thinking of that at the time.
And it's something really cool that you guys do, is that you get some kind of unknown drummer, like a fan, and they win a chance to get up and play.
We're all Bonzo wannabes, because at the end of the day, really, you know, every time you do one of those licks, you go, oh, does that sound as good as Bonham? No, but it's still a good try. You know? Yeah, but
give it that try, man.
But man, there's so many, how do you say it? Yeah, there's great, you know, well-known, famous drummers that get up there and kick ass. But then there's also something to be said for the person that isn't as known that gets up there and people go, holy shit, listen to that.
Yeah.
Okay, for one, John Hummel in Jersey. He played on Lady Gaga's original like demos that got her the deals on.
Right.
But this dude's groove is this combination of, it's a Bonzo, DeRozier, Ian Pace, piece kind of groove. It's like you put it all together and you listen and play, and it's all the phrasing and the groove and the snap and the pizzazz and the punch. It's all like, you know, and I'm friends with him from back in the day, but I hadn't heard him play in a long time. Then his band ended up opening up for Foreigner in Connecticut, and I heard it across the back parking lot. I heard the pop of the snare, and I heard it, and I went,
yeah,
something's going on. Went over the to the stage, and he's playing this old school Ludwig Sparkle 26, you know, 14, 16, 18, superphonic thing, and I heard it all, and you could just see it all, and I was like, he looks kind of familiar. He came up, that's John Hummel. Holy shit, it's John. I didn't see him a lot. I'm like, dude, you're like he's one of the biggest grooves of anybody I know. It's amazing.
Awesome.
And then Courtney D'Augustine, she plays with Frank Hannon. She closes the Bonzo Bash by singing. Nobody else had done this yet, singing Stairway to Heaven behind the kit, and then busts in the drums and plays and finishes the song, singing lead and playing Stairway to Heaven.
Wow!
And the thing
Pretty
is,
epic.
That's already cool. But if you listen to Courtney play, because I remember Frank Hannon going, "Dude, you should have Courtney in the show, man. She's really good." And I'm like, "Well, she's playing with Frank." And then months later, we all did a show together, and I was like, "She's badass. She really is." Not to mention Nikki Glaspie, who played with Beyonce. She comes into the rehearsals in New York last year, and I'm just like, you can just, you know what I mean? When you feel something like that bit, like that
Berkeley.
Kind of groove,
yeah.
when you just can't help but notice a groove, that says so much, you know, and she had it. And I was just like, She was killer. She can't make it this
so
year.
So many people killed that night, man. You sounded great, both on drums and guitar. And then, Jason Sutter played, We're Gonna Groove, and I thought he really fucking killed it.
Yeah. So let's throw some drummers out that are playing this year.
Sure.
We have a, I'm really happy this is happening because he was our first Bonzo Bash Legend Award winner, Peter Crisp, but he is my first drum teacher. Like, I really think about it. That's where I learned to play the rock drums, was the Kiss records. Like, he was the first. Kiss was the first band. Nobody was more important in those first couple of years, you know what I mean? So when we thought there was a chance last year he would make it, I was like, Peter Crisp, this doesn't come to a Bonzo Bash and hang out. Peter Crisp, there's a bigger thing going on for me personally and pretty much for anybody that's around my age. So we're like, we got to give, this has got to be a legend award going on. Yeah. And Carmine, a piece was hosting. Carmine is, if you look at the world of drummers, somebody who lives their life for everything drums, and you don't mention Carmine, you're forgetting something real big. You know, I mean, first of all, the guy's an amazing player. We all know that. But right. What he's done, what his life is about, he's just such one of the biggest ambassadors for all things drums. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm like, well, we got to give it to both of them. So we gave two awards because he was kind of like, oh, you're giving it to Peter? He's kind of like on the side of the stage. And then we go, wait, hold on. Because Peter thanked Carmine in there, you know?
Sure.
Because Peter knew we were giving it to Carmine, but Carmine didn't know. So he's crying Carmine because Carmine's like, oh, Pete's getting, he's like, because Carmine's been with this from day one. Because from the first show, I was like, Carmine, you got to play this. You know, you're the history. There's really very few people who can speak of those days. I mean, almost nobody. He's the head honcho. Right. And here comes Bonzo. Right. And there you got these two touring together. And Bonzo was learning from Karma. That whole history is amazing. That's history that we all were affected by. You know, you might not know the exact story, but you were affected by what those two had going on at that time. Yeah. You know what I mean? Because DeRozier will go, Carmine, before there was a Zeppelin, it's Carmine. He is the power rock. He's the power rock drummer. He's the guy. That's it. And then all of a sudden, now you got this guy, who was listening to him coming over and taking over this Led Zeppelin band, becoming the biggest band in the world. And if you haven't listened to Cactus is Evil, go check out Carmine on that. That's a badass track. But the guys that are coming, okay, we got Peter Crisp is showing up to hang, which is great. And that's great enough, right there. But man, who's playing? We got Bobby Rondinelli, showing up. Danny Schuller from Biohazard, Ron Lipnicki from Overkill, Chad Zaliga, who's now with Scott Stapp, he was with Black Label Society, he just confirmed that he's available. Corky Lang's coming from Mountain. Corky's a trip. He's awesome. Wow. I'm so happy he's going to make it. Will Calhoun from Living Color is coming.
Oh, yeah, Will's going to be there.
Yeah, Will can make it this time, we're sure. It's good things like that happen. Eight kick drums, dude. Eight kick drums, and you put your stamp on this planet. Dude, pan it left to right, pan the four to left, pan the four right. Like,
that's amazing.
How could people playing the cowbell, dude?
Big.
How can people keep up with what you're doing? Just Facebook? Everything Facebook?
Facebook.
YouTube fun stuff. There's a bunch of speedbag clips up there. You got it, yeah.
May 31st.
May 31st, Bonzo Bash, and Randy Rhoads, remember, for the week after with a bunch of killer guitar players. If you're, if you're a drummer who's at a guitar playing like I am, that rules too.
Brian, awesome. Dude, thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah,
and safe travels and have a great tour.
Thanks for having me, you guys.
Have a great tour this summer as well.
Oh, yeah, Dead Daisies.
Yeah.
July with Skinner and Bad Company and August with Kiss and Def Leppard.
Sick.
Dude. That's epic.
And they let me go crazy. They encouraged the
craziness. You are living the dream, my friend.
That's good for you.
Love it.
You're gonna wash some dishes, what would you gonna do to this, okay? I love the sound effects in this place, it's great. This is Moak. You're watching Drumsmack on T Radio V. Check it out, for drummers only.